How are you? Welcome to this Fiverr Academy course in the scope of the cloud hosting chapter and regarding this self-service interfaces cloud portal generic enabler. This is the second lesson of this course in which I'm going to show you an overview of the functionalities that the cloud portal user interface offers to the users and the developers. I will explain before the live demo several concepts regarding projects, regarding regions, and also regarding the Fiverr app environment, because as you know, this component can be installed by yourself in your own infrastructure, of course, but in order to show you the concepts during this course, I will use in every moment the running instance that we have deployed in the Fiverr Lab environment. Okay, so which is the Fiverr Lab environment? It's our non-commercial environment in which we are providing all the Fiverr technologies that we offer inside the project in order to allow you to start playing with them and start to taking a look to all the technologies and the components in Fiverr. Okay. A project in the scope of OpenStack and also in the scope of Fiverr is a virtual environment where you and other authorized users can share cloud resources. Okay, at least in this scope, in the scope of the identity, that means other things, also other things. And finally, as I introduced in the first lesson, we have this Fiverr Lab environment deployed in several nodes, in several regions among Europe and among America. So, using the cloud portal, you will be able to access to deploy your resources in several nodes, in several regions. Okay. An important thing that you need to know here is the different Fiverr Lab account types that we are using. I'm not going to enter in details in this lesson, in this course, about that, because we have a specific course in the security chapter regarding identity management, regarding how these account types work and how to upgrade your account to a community account, for instance. But it's important here to know that in order to use the cloud resources, you need to have a trial or a community account. If not, you can ask another trial or community user to allow you to access the resources using his or her organization. Okay. Here are some links to documentation, of course, the main page of Fiverr Lab, the documentation of OpenStack as it is, and also the Cloud Portal Generic Enabler documentation. The link to those identity management lessons, and an entry in the wiki in which we explain how to upgrade to a community account to start using cloud resources. Okay, so now I'm going to show you in the cloud portal site how it is organized and how to start working with it. Okay, here you can see that entering in the cloud portal main page, as I explained before, this is totally linked to the Fiverr identity part. So the first thing that I have to do here is to log in using my Fiverr account. Okay, if you don't have a Fiverr account, you can create a new one. But again, this is a thing that I explain you in the identity management courses. So assuming that you already have a Fiverr account, and using the OAuth2 protocol, this system is authorizing me inside the platform. Okay, so if I sign in, it will redirect me to the main page of the cloud portal graphical user interface. Okay. If everything works, yes, right now, I will see the main page of the cloud portal. Okay, that is this one. So here you can see how it is structured. In the left side we have the different options that we can perform here. The main thing is the projects in which I have the rights to start deploying cloud resources. Right now I'm only authorized in this one, so I cannot switch between projects, but if I belong to another project, it will appear here. Here in the info button I can retrieve some information regarding this project. Here is the blueprint section that is that corresponds to this PaaS manager component, in which I can deploy blueprints, configure my own blueprint templates that are advanced application, complex applications. Here is also an important switcher that allows me to select in which of the available regions I want to start deploying my resources. Okay, and here I have the different services of OpenStack. The first one is the compute one, then the storage, and then the networking part. Okay, as you can hear, this part is the main part in which I will see the list of instances, for the list of security groups, and so on. And here I have the access to the rest of Fireware Lab application. Okay, finally, here I can access to the settings of my account, and of course I can sign out. So. And this is the overview of the cloud portal page, and in the next lessons I will start showing you each of these one functionalities. So many thanks and see you in the next lesson. Bye.